Hey guys, Josh Stern with the Stern Team Keller Williams, helping you realize all of your real estate dreams across the entire Wasatch Front. Today we get to talk about the 2017 report card for the Wasatch Front, and we're going to start with the single family homes. So single family home sales down slightly over 2016, about 3.5% to be exact. That's 28,000 single family homes that sold in the past year. Still pretty strong, right? In fact, if we go back to the previous height of the market in 2006, where 29,300 single family homes sold, it was our strongest sales year in terms of single family home selling. So we came very, very close to that this year. Our average sale price along the Wasatch Front this year was up about 6% year over year. So in 2016, it was $305,000. Now we're up to $323,000, all right? And we see that because of the limited availability of entry-level housing along with the luxury market beginning to pick up some momentum. We've seen pricing along the Wasatch Front just continue to increase. So 2016, we're up 7% over 2015. We were up 6% over 2016. So home prices have increased about 16% over the last couple of years. When we look back at the last 40 years, we'll see an average increase of about 3.2% year over year. Again, that's inventory shortage for the entry-level home. It's also luxury homes beginning to move, and it's an indicator of Utah's growing population and new home builders' inability to keep up with the demand. So our housing desires are higher than our availability, with our population growing as rapidly as it is. We're just unable to keep up. So it's a great time to be a home seller and move up and take advantage of the market. So let's talk about condos and townhomes along the Wasatch Front. We're about the same in terms of the amount sold over 2016, that's 8,000, and same amount basically in 2017. But if you remember, 2016 was a record year in terms of the amount of condos and townhome sales. So we, just to say it, had another record year. The average price condo slash townhome sold along the Wasatch Front was just over $209,000, which is an 8.4% increase over 2016 sale price of $193,000. Again, this is a record high average price for these types of homes, but keep in mind that just over 20% of these sales were actually new construction. 1 in 5 condos or townhomes sold along the Wasatch Front were actually new construction, and they're priced naturally a little bit higher from the resale side. So what do we expect in 2018? Here's what the media is talking about right now in regard to the Wasatch Front housing market. Salt Lake City was named number 6 in the top 10 housing markets for 2018's national forecast. And PricewaterhouseCoopers and the Urban Land Institute ranked for the very first time Salt Lake City number 3 on the US market to watch list. We've never actually been there before. Additionally, we made number six in the top 10 housing market from Realtor.com's 2018 national housing forecast. So it seems like we'll have the Wasatch Front sunny side up for breakfast. Finally, let's talk interest rate. Last time we assumed that we would see interest rates approach that 5% mark. Well, we were wrong, but we weren't the only ones. All the experts assumed that rates would hit or exceed that mark by the end of 2017. Lawrence Young, who is the chief economist for the National Association of Realtors, expects that this year we're gonna see interest rates average out around 4.6% on that 30-year fixed rate loan. Realtor.com's experts are expecting rates to hit about 5% by the end of 2018 due to stronger economic growth, inflationary pressure, and monetary policy normalization in the year ahead, if that actually happens. Things are looking strong here along the Wasatch Front. So if you'd like to get a free valuation on your home or learn about buying or investing in real estate, I hope you're going to send me an email or give me a call, because that's what we're here for. Thanks again for watching. Hopefully you were able to digest all this info.